friends, I am Sujit and we are going to discuss about the internal ADC of PIC18F4520 microcontroller. So related with ADC, we will study the basics of ADC first and then we will go for the internal ADC of PIC microcontroller. Related with ADC, ADC will require 8 to 14 analog input channels. I'm talking about the internal ADC of PIC microcontroller. So this ADC may have 8 to 14 analog input channels, and related with ADC, ADC will require A to D clock frequency, then followed by it will require the V reference voltage plus V reference minus voltage. Then in order to select one of the analog input channels, it will also require the channel selection bits. If your ADC is having 8 to 13 analog input channels, then it may have 3 to 4 channel select lines for selecting the channel from which we are going to provide the analog input. Then the clock frequency, which is required for conversion of that analog value into the digital one. So related with this, we will require the A to D clock frequency also. One more thing, that is we will require the go / done pin. So related with go is nothing but your start of conversion. So that means you are giving the instruction or command to the ADC that start the conversion. Done, it indicates the end of conversion, that is analog to digital conversion has been taken place. And in order to store that result, whatever digital result we got, that will be stored in one of the registers of the internal ADC of the PIC microcontroller. So we have studied the basics of the ADC. So what are the different components of the ADC? First of all, ADC will require analog input channels, then it will require A to D clock frequency, then it will require V reference plus, that is V reference minus pins, then ground, then it will require the digital output pin, it will require the start of conversion and the end of conversion pins. So if we look at the internal ADC, it is one of the module which is present inside of the PIC microcontroller. So in order to control this ADC, we will require different control registers. The registers which are related with the internal ADC module of the PIC microcontroller are, first is ADCON 0 register, ADCON 1 register, ADCON 2 register, then A to D result register higher 8 bits, that is address H you can call, then A to D result register lower 8 bits, that is address L register you can call. So these are the 5 registers and we are going to discuss about these 5 registers. So we will start with ADCON 0 register, then ADCON 1, ADCON 2, and then address H and address L. So before that, as discussed earlier, so we have studied the basics of the ADC. Now we will study about the internal ADC of the PIC microcontroller. It may have analog input channels from 8 to 13. The result which is converted from analog into the digital, that digital result will be stored in address H as well as address L register. Why we will require two registers? These are two 8 bit registers. In this, your internal ADC is 10 bit ADC. It means that the result of analog input voltage which is going to be converted, that will be the digital one, and it will be stored in this register address H and address L, but in 10 bit binary form. So 8 bits will be taken from one of the registers. Out of this two, 8 bits will be used of one of the register and 2 bits of the other register. So there are two formats in case of internal ADC. We can call that format as a right justified format or left justified format. So we will study about that in case of ADCON 0 and ADCON 1 registers explanation. So we will start with the ADCON 0 and ADCON 1 register explanation. So we were talking about the right justified format and left justified format. If I am storing that result in right justified format, its meaning is lower 8 bits of the result will be stored in A to D result register L, and upper 2 bits will be stored in address H register, and the higher 6 bits of address H register will be unused. Similarly, if it is left justified format, then that 10 bit result will be stored out of that 10 bit result, 8 bits will be stored from address H register, 2 bits from the address L, and lower 6 bits will be unused. So this is the case in case of write justified and left justified format. So we will start about the explanation of ADCON 0 and ADCON 1 register. But before that, we should provide some analog input to the ADC. So we will connect the 0 to 5 volt DC supply with the help of variable resistor, and we will connect that to one of the input channels. So we can have analog input channels from AN0 to AN13. In case of internal ADC, we can have 8 to 13 channels. So we will go for the explanation of ADCON 0, how to configure that internal ADC module of the PIC microcontroller. So ADCON 0 register is an 8 bit register whose higher 2 bits are reserved, then followed by channel selection bits. 4 bits are required for the channel selection because we may have 8 to 13 channels. So CHS3, CHS2, CHS1, CHS0. So these are the channel selection bits. So if the status of all these 4 bits is 0, that means we are selecting channel 0, that is analog channel 0. Then followed by go / done bit, then followed by AD on bit. In order to turn on that ADC module, we have to make this bit as 1. AD on equal to 1, ADC is on. Go / done bit. So as discussed earlier, ADC will require start of conversion command as well as end of conversion command. So go means start of conversion and done means it is end of conversion. So we have to keep monitoring this bit in the program. So related with channel selections, as we are keeping the status as 4 times 0, or finally we are going to keep its status as 111. So related with channel selections, if the status of CHS3, CHS2, CHS1 and CHS0, if all these bits are 0, the channel 0 will be selected, analog channel 0, which belongs to the RH0 pin. Similarly, if it is 0001, then channel 1 will be selected. Now we will go for the explanation of next control register, that is ADCON1, whose higher 2 bits are reserved, then followed by voltage configuration bits. 2 bits are related with voltage configuration. As discussed earlier, ADC will require V reference plus as well as V reference minus. So VCFG1 and VCFG0 bits plays a role into that. VCFG1 bit, if its status is 1, then your voltage, V reference voltage, will be V reference minus analog channel input voltage. And if it is 0, that means it is connected to the VSS, that is ground. Similarly, if the VCFG0 bit, that is voltage reference bit, if that bit is equal to 1, then your reference voltage is V reference plus analog channel input voltage 3. And if it is 0, then that means it is connected to the VDD. So in normal practice or in normal programming, we have to keep both these bits at 0. VCFG1 equal to 0, that means it is connected to ground, and VCFG0 is equal to 0, that means it is connected to the VDD, that is VCC supply. Then followed by 4 bits, which is related with port configuration bits. So we are having 4 bits into that. PCFG3, PCFG2, PCFG1, PCFG0. So in this bits, we can configure those pins which are used as analog channels. We can configure those pins for normal digital input output purpose. So depending upon the status, if all these bits from this ADCON 1 register are 00, then all the pins from 8 to 13 can be used as analog channel pins. But if we want to use those pins as for our digital input output purpose, then we can keep its status as 4 times 1. That means all the bits from PCFG3 to PCFG0 will be equal to 1. Next register is ADCON 2. In ADCON 2 register, the MSB bit is ADFM, that is address format bit. ADFM stands for A to D result format select bit. Whether we have to go for the write justified format or left justified format, if that ADFM bit is 1, then we are storing that result into the write justified format. That means address L will consist of 8 bits and address H will consist of 2 bits. Similarly, if ADFM is equal to 0, then it is left justified format. Your result will be stored in left justified format. 8 bits from address H, 2 bits from address L. Lower 8 bits will be reserved. We have discussed that point earlier. Then followed by the 2 bits, that is acquisition time selection bits. You can call this as a A to D acquisition time select bits. So related with ADC, if a particular voltage is present at the ADC channel, then you should give that ADC some time to remain that voltage as a fixed voltage. Means if that analog voltage is fluctuating, then that voltage should be present on that pin for that while. So you should provide some time delay for the ADC. So that's why this A to D acquisition. Acquisition means we are going to acquire that voltage and we are providing some delay. So it depends upon the frequency, A to D clock frequency which is used. So mostly we are going to keep its status as 000. That means 0 TAD. Delay should be less as possible. Depending upon the programmer, we can select that bits. If its status is 111, then it will be 20 times the TAD, that is time selection bits, that is A to D conversion time period. 20 times the time A to D conversion time period. Then followed by next 2 bits of the ADCON 2 register are ADCS2, ADCS1 and ADCS0. These 3 bits are responsible for the selection of the clock frequency. As discussed earlier, ADC will require A to D clock frequency. So what is that frequency range? Whether we are going for the crystal frequency divided by 2, crystal frequency divided by the 8, crystal frequency divided by 32, it depends upon us, or whether we are going for the internal RC oscillator frequency, that is 32 kilohertz. So these 3 bits plays very important role in selection of that frequency. It may be 00, it may be 0110 or 11. So that is nothing but the A to D clock selection bits. So this is the explanation of different internal registers of ADC microcontroller, internal ADC of the PIC microcontroller. Related with A to D result register, we have studied its concept also. So in order to program the ADC, we have to follow some steps. We have to program, we have to load the different values into the ADCON 0, ADCON 1 and ADCON 2 register. We will get result into the ADC. So if you like this video, please subscribe and share my channel. Stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you and happy WikiNote.